Yoohoo! Hello traders, welcome to my channel. It's Rocket Trading. In this channel you will learn about money management, about how to trade with the trends, and also how to predict the market movement and also amazing stuff. So copy, hit the subscribe button and like the video and comment. So today will be a mind-blowing video, guys. So I've tell you, today will be a very mind-blowing video. I am not going to waste time, so this is a mind-blowing video. I will continue it because it will be a very long video. Today's topic is about how you can trade with inverted hammer. How you can trade with inverted hammer. How you can make it a sure shot. Okay, let's see what is an inverted hammer. An inverted hammer is a type of candlestick pattern found after a downtrend or an uptrend. So sometimes it is a trend reversal signal, but mostly it is a continuation sign. So the inverted hammer look at the outside version of a hammer candlestick pattern. So it is a hammer candlestick pattern. So for not make it complicated, a hammer need to have a small lower body and a long upper wick, which is two times as the large of the body. The body should be small. So I will show you something. Okay, imagine you are having an uptrend and you have a hammer, an inverted hammer. What you need to do is, you see, here is the SNR level. Where it rejected is an SNR level. How you can trade with inverted hammer, I will show you. So what you need to do is you need to have a rejection. This is a rejection. Rejection, if you check on 5 seconds confirmation, this is where sellers enter, and after sometimes the strong buyers enter, which will make a rejection in 1 minute expiry time. So you need to a rejection at this level in the middle of the hammer. So you need a rejection. If this price go up, so you can place your trade. Firstly, you need a rejection. Okay, the trend is going up, the level is here, you need a rejection at this level. Okay, so when to trade it, you need some criteria. Firstly, the market should be uptrend. Okay, the minor trend should be uptrend. Uptrend means that the buyers are in control, so it's better to follow the trend, which is the buyers. And this candle, if you see here, there are no rejection from sellers, so there are no sellers interested. And as you see here, it made a new high. I will talk about this candlestick psychology. This is a very mind-blowing video, so guys, subscribe and like the video. So the first thing you need is you need to get a rejection first at the middle point of the hammer. So you need a rejection. Okay, rejection means that sellers first enter. If you check in 5 second confirmation, you see that sellers have entered and a strong buyers enter, which means that which means that this is a bullish engulfing. Buyers are strong and the next candle will go up. So you need a rejection at the middle of this point, and you place your trade. If you get a rejection at this point, you place a higher option, and this is a sure shot, guys. This is a sure shot because the market is in uptrend, the sellers are here, and this shows that buyers are powerful. If you see, buyers are very powerful and they are momentum. Okay, so seller will not enter because there is no lower rejection here, so seller will not enter. Okay, so if you follow this, it is a sure shot. You can make some money with it, guys. So I'm giving you this stuff for free. Please hit the subscribe button because this channel will help you, guys. I have told you it will help you, so subscribe. Okay, so the criteria need to market should be uptrend, the minor trend should be uptrend. No rejection, which means that there are no sellers. Okay, there are no sellers. The strong sellers area is here. Those say awesome, guys. The buyer will continue it to this level. Okay, this way you can trade with hammer candlestick. Okay, so I will show you how when to not take trades. Okay, if for example there are a row number here, let me show you. There are a row number here. I will make a video on round number. Don't worry, if you guys don't know what is round number, comment below, I will make a video on it. So if there are a round number here, you don't place your trade. Don't place your trade because this shows the selling pressure. Okay, don't place your trade because even if you get a rejection here, the price come up and again it come up. Again, seller will come. So don't place your trade if there are wrong number. Okay, don't place your trade when if there are a wrong number. And I will show you something else. If there are momentum, there are no momentum, which means that there are no momentum. Momentum refers to that there are four candles consecutively, two or three candles consecutively. So if there are no momentum, so this, if there are no momentum and there is a strong selling, there are strong buyers and sellers area, the it will go down. So what you need is you need a good momentum, you need a momentum and you need a rejection. That's what you need to take the trade. So if there is a strong buyers area, a strong sellers and buyers area, if you guys watch my video on support and resistance, you will understand. If there are a strong buyers or sellers area, if there are a strong sellers area, the market will go down because this will show the selling pressure. So what you need to do is, you wait the rejection come at this level, okay? You wait for the rejection come at this level in the middle of this candle, and as soon as you have a rejection, you place your trade high. But if you see that there is a wrong number, a strong buyers and sellers area, don't place your trade. You can place your trade if there are a weak buyers and sellers. I will show you on my next video what I mean by weak buyers and sellers. So if there is a weak buyers and seller, you place your trade a high option because sellers have already entered and buyers are strong, and also the trend is up. So if there are weak buyers and sellers area, for example, if you see only one candle, red, green, okay, let me show you, green. So if there is a weak buyers and sellers area, you wait for the rejection and you place your trade. This is a sure shot, guys. So you need a rejection, okay? If there are strong sellers and buyers area, don't place your trade. If there is any price action in the past, don't place your trade. What do I mean by price action is buyers and sellers area, round number, okay? So if there are these things in the post, don't place your trade, okay? So some people don't know what is hammer. Hammer should have a long wick which is greater than the body, and the body need to be small. So if you're going to trade, you need to know what is hammer. It should have a long wick and the body should be small. This is a sure shot, guys. So you need a rejection after the price reject here. So you place your trade a high option, and I am sure you it will be a winning trade because it is a new high. The psychology is that it made a new high. There are some gaps between the buyers and sellers. There are no selling pressure because there are no weak up down. If there is a weak down, it will be a spinning top, which means that the buyer is still powerful and are determined to push the price higher. And you have trained with the trend, not against the trend, so you have more possibility to win the trade. So you will win this trade because this is a sure shot, guys. Please practice it and you will see it is a sure shot. So guys, please subscribe to my channel, it's Rocket Trading, and please subscribe. I have already 12 subscribers and I want to grow my YouTube channel. Like and comment below your strong. Comment if you have doubt in any subject, I will make some videos about it. So comment and goodbye. Have a nice day.